So I'll just give a quick review of what we have talked about in the last class, then we are going to move on to the next topic. So in the last class, we were talking about that there are two group of techniques that we apply. There are two group of techniques that we apply to evaluate any investment proposal. First is traditional method or non-discounting method, in which the time value of money is ignored. The concept of time value of money is completely ignored in these two techniques. And in these four techniques, we take into account the time value of money. What is the principle of time value of money? The principle of time value of money states that the money that is receivable today is more valuable as compared to the amount of money that will be receivable sometime in the future. So first is net present value. That means we will calculate the net present value. By that, I mean the present value of cash inflow. Whatever amount I'll be receiving in the future, I'll calculate the present value. By present value, I mean if I have received all that amount today, what would be the amount that I would be receiving? And then I'll compare to that amount with the amount that is I'm spending or that I'm investing in that project. And if the return is positive, then I'll accept. If the return is negative, then I will reject the proposal. Next is profitability index. I was talking about profitability index in the last class. So profitability index means, since if the situation is like this, there are a lot of projects that you have to compare amongst themselves and you have to select the best project. So for comparison, a basic thing is that the ground should be equal. For comparison, the ground for comparison should be equal, should be same. Only then the comparison is possible. So if you have only one project and you want to identify what is the advantage, then you will use NPV method of evaluation. If we talk about a lot of projects, for example, the example that we're talking about, yes, there are four projects A, B, C, and D. If you want to compare amongst all these projects and you want to select the best of these projects, then you will use profitability index method. You will use profitability index method. Okay, clear? So because whenever you calculate ratio, whenever you calculate percentage, the base is always 100, or in case of ratio, the base is always same. Okay, one. Clear? I hope this is clear to you. So this was all about present value. Next, we will talk about discounted payback period. Discounted payback period. What is the meaning of discounted payback period? We first of all, we'll talk a little bit about payback period. What is payback period? Payback period means the time it takes for a project to recover okay. What is discounted payback period? Discounted payback period is the time it takes for a project to recover the initial investment. Recover the initial investment. Okay. But the drawback or the limitation of this technique is that the principle of time value of money is ignored. And to correct that, and to make sure that that does not happen, to correct that, what we're going to do is we are going to apply the principle of time value of money to discounted payback to payback period. And this would be called discounted payback period. Clear? In the normal payback period, see if you look over here, if you look here closely, in the traditional techniques, we use this payback period. That means we just take the inflows, we add all the inflows, and we calculate the time it will take to recover the amount. Okay? But discounted payback period means we'll do the same thing. We'll calculate the payback period, but instead of net cash flows or the gross cash flows, we will use discounted cash flow. That is the only difference. When I was talking about payback period, I was taking into the amount that was given to us, the inflow that is given to us, that was, that is what I was taking into account. But when I'm talking about discounted payback period, I will discount those cash inflows to the present value. And then with that present value, I will calculate the payback period. The method of calculation of payback period, the technique remains the same. I'll just open the file again. Okay. The next technique is IRR, but we'll talk about IRR later on. And see, this book is uploaded on your Moodle and you can study with this book. But this book has a lot of things that are not relevant for your standard, for your DBA. Okay, so you are advised to remove or to ignore those topics and only study the topics that are important for your exam. Let me just find where it discounted payback period. You okay? Discounted payback period method. Some accountants prefer to calculate payback period after discounting the cash flows by predetermined rate and payback period. It also called discounted payback period. One of the most popular economic criteria for evaluating capital projects also is the payback period. Payback period is the time required for cumulative cash inflows to recover the cash outflow of the project. For example, let's take an example. A 30,000 cash outlay for a project with the annual cash inflows of 6,000 would have a payback period of 5 years. Okay, 30,000 divided by 6, that is 5 years. The problem with the payback period is that it ignores the time value of money. In order to correct this, we can use discounted cash flows in calculating the payback period. Referring back to our example, if we discount the cash flows and the cash flow is 6,000 for 10 years, okay? So I'll calculate the present value factor. I'll show you again how to calculate the present value factor. It is 1 divided by 1.15 because the rate is 15%. The rate would always be given during the question. You don't have to worry about the rate. Just understand this calculation is 0.8695. We can use it 0.870. It is 0.870. Okay. For the second year, I'll press equal to. This is the discounting factor for the second year. That is 0.756. Then I'll again press equal to. Now the discounting factor is 0.658. Because it's 5, whenever we reach 5, we round off to the next figure. It is 0.658. Then I can press equal to again. It will be 0.572. Okay. Is it clear? This is how we calculate the present value factor for the year that is given to us. If 10 years given, we will calculate for 10 years. Then we calculate the present value by multiplying cash flow and PV factor. And this is the cumulative present value, right? Because the inflow is not same. If you remember payback period, okay, the inflow is not same. So we'll calculate the cumulative present value. How do we calculate present value? Cumulative present value, 5,220 for the first year. For the second year, 5,220 plus 4,536. This is the cumulative present value. What this means is, what is the amount that you have recovered after 2 years? So we have recovered first year and we have recovered 4,536 in the second year. The total amount that we have recovered at the end of second year is 9,756. Then what is the amount that you have recovered at the end of third year? The amount is 13,704 and so on. Look at this arrow. The total investment was 30,000. So the amount you will recover 30,000 in the 10th year. Okay. So this is discounting payback period. Clear to everyone? Is it clear to you what we are doing, what we're trying to do? Do you understand the gross concept? What is happening? Okay. So now moving on, I'll talk about IRR. That is the last method of capital budgeting, and that is the last technique that we use to evaluate the decision. After this, the chapter is going to be over, and we would have completed your unit 4th. And in the next class, that is on Monday or Tuesday, I guess, we'll start with unit 5th, that is working capital management. So tomorrow is Sunday. So all of you are requested to please go through this chapter. If there is any problem, then please ask me on Tuesday. And all the videos are already uploaded on YouTube. So please go and watch those videos if there is any problem. So I'll just give you a brief. Okay, so we have talked about discounted payback. We have talked about profitability index. Now the only method that we'll talk about is internal rate of return. Although this is not that relevant, not that important from BBA's perspective, but still we'll talk about it. We'll solve a few questions. We'll not go in that much detail, but you should know what it is and how it is applied. Okay. So the topic is internal rate of return. Okay. Before starting with this topic, I want to talk a little more about all the other techniques. What is happening in all other techniques? I'm talking about a net present value. I'm talking about profitability index. I'm talking about discounted payback period. What is happening? We have a cost of capital. Okay. Or the minimum required rate of return. We are using this rate. For example, let's say the rate is 12%. We are using this rate to calculate the present value of inflow, and then we are solving the question. IIR takes a different approach. What IIR says is, you compare and calculate another rate, which is IRR. Okay. And then we will compare cost of capital and IRR. If the IRR of the project is more than cost of capital, if the selection decision is going to be like this, okay, if IRR is more than cost of overall cost of capital, then we will accept the project. But what this means is, if the cost of capital is less, let's say cost is 12%, and the project is yielding 13%, 14%, 15%, then we will accept the project. Okay. And if IRR is less than overall cost of capital, then we will reject the project, because the cost is 12% and the return is 11%, 10%, 9%, whatever. Then in that case, we will reject the proposal. So IRR takes a different approach to the techniques of capital budgeting. All other techniques are taking cost of capital as the base, and then they are calculating the value of the investment in regards to this cost of capital. IRR takes a different approach. IRR says that no, we'll calculate a rate first, and then we'll compute, or then we'll compare that rate with the cost of capital. If the investment is beneficial, if the investment is more than the cost of capital, if the investment is more than the amount I have to pay to the providers of funds, then I will accept the proposal. If it is less, then I will reject the proposal. Okay. Now, what is IRR? In that case, what is IRR? What is the rate, and how do we calculate IRR? Internal rate. Okay. So internal rate is a rate at which PV of cash inflow is equal to PV of cash outflow. I'll repeat myself. Please pay attention. It is a little bit difficult. IRR is a little bit difficult, but it's okay. We just have to understand the basics, and we will not go in that much detail, but you should know what it is, and you know what is happening, all those things. IRR, PV of cash inflow is equal to PV of cash outflow. Okay. So we will calculate a rate that makes this equation possible. What is happening is, see, PV of cash outflow is always given to us in the question. We always know what is the amount that we have to invest, that we have to invest 1 lakh rupees, or we have to invest 10 lakh rupees, or we have to invest 1 crore rupees. That is always known in the question. So PV of cash outflow is always known in the question. We will calculate PV of cash inflow. This is what we have to calculate. But this is what we have to calculate. This is what we were calculating before as well. But now for this calculation, instead of using the rate or rate that is given to us, or the cost of capital, or the minimum required rate of return, we will calculate a new rate. We'll calculate a rate at which cash outflow is equal to cash inflow. And then we'll compare that rate with the cost of capital. Just give me 1 second. I'll explain with the help of an example. Please take it. Internal rate of return method considers the time value of money, the initial cash investment, and all cash flow from the investment. But unlike the net present value method, the internal rate of return method does not use the desired rate of return. Okay, it does not use the minimum required rate of return. It does not use the cost of capital. Okay, but estimates the discount rate that makes the present value of subsequent cash flows equal to the initial investment. This discount rate is IRR. But in all the previous question, the discount rate was given to you in the question, and you just had to calculate the discounting factor, and you have to calculate the present value of cash inflow, and then we used to compare the PV of cash inflow to the initial investment. In this question, the rate is not given to you. You have to calculate the rate. What is the rate at which the present value of cash inflow equals to the present value of cash outflow? So we will try to estimate the rate, and we will use hit and trial method. I'll teach cash karenge. Okay. So calculating IRR. The procedure for computing the internal return may vary with the pattern of cash flow over the useful life of the investment. Say everyone. Yes, the first thing. For an investment with uniform cash flows over your life, for example, what this means is that every year you are receiving a fixed amount that is same for every year. The following equation is used. Total initial investment is equal to annual cash flow into annual discount factor for the discount rate for the number of period for the investment useful life. Very easy term. Okay, I'll explain it in very easy terms. What this says is, okay, first point, when cash inflows are equal, we'll form an equation. Equation is equal to initial investment is equal to total, no, not total, equals to cash inflow into discount factor. But this is what we're doing. If I take you back to the net present value method, what are we doing? To the cash inflow that is given to us in the question, we are applying this discount factor and we are calculating the present value of the cash inflow. In the IRR method, what we'll do is we'll make an equation. The discount factor is X. We don't know what is the discount factor. Okay. And we have to equate the cash inflow with the initial investment. For example, I'll take an example. Okay. Please be patient. Just give me some 10, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. You will understand everything. Discount factor is X. Cash inflow would be given to you in the question. For example, the inflow is 6,000. Let's say, let's just assume an amount, 6,000. And the initial investment is 30,000. Okay. So we'll divide 30 divided by 6,000. This gives us 5. So X is 5. So discount factor is 5. So we will calculate. Now there's a table. There's a table that will be given to you at statistical table. Usme all the values will be given to you. But we'll see, for example, if the cash inflow is for 5 years. So we'll see what is the rate, 10%, 12%, 13%, 14%, 9%, 8%. What is the rate that becomes rupees 5 in 5 years? And that rate would be the internal rate of return. Okay, I'll explain with the help of an example. Please pay attention. Okay, देखिए, I have a question, I have an illustration. Please pay attention. A Limited is evaluating a project involving an outlay of 10 lakh. So the investment is 10 lakh. Cash outlay, outflow is 10 lakh rupees, resulting in an annual cash inflow of 2,50,000 for 6 years. Assuming salvage value of the project is zero, determine the IRR of the project. Okay, determine the IRR of the project. Clear? So I'll just write this down. Okay, question. The initial cash outflow is 10 lakh. Cash inflow is 2,50,000 for 2,50,000 for 6 years. Okay, so just put this information in the formula. Equation is equal to cash outflow is equal to cash inflow, or I'll write periodic cash inflow, that would be better. This is periodic cash inflow into cumulative discount factor or discount factor. Okay, discount factor for the years. So cash outflow is 10 lakh. Periodic cash inflow is 250,000. This is equal to the cumulative discount factor. Okay, if I divide. So 4 is equal to cumulative discount factor. So what we'll do is we will refer to the table. We'll refer to the table, and in that table we will see what rate, or at what rate, okay, at what rate 1 rupee becomes 4 in 6 years. In 6 years, what we'll see, we'll see at what rate rupees 1 becomes 6, rupees 1 becomes 4 rupees in 1 year. That will be the rate, and that rate would be known as internal rate of return. Abhi, how to use the table and everything, I'll show you in 2 minutes. Please be patient. This is the basic outflow, this is the basic outline, basic structure of what we will be doing. This is only applicable when there is equal cash inflows. Okay, when there is equal cash inflows, this equation is applicable only when there is equal cash inflows. I hope that is clear to everyone. Okay, okay. Now how to use the table and everything, let's go back to the question. Dekhiye kya bol raha hai. Four. Now we shall use this figure in the PVF table. PVF means present value annuity factor table, corresponding to 6 years, because the life of the project is 6 years. The value 4 lies between 4.111 and 3.98. Correspondingly, discounting rate 12% and 30% respectively. I'll just show you the table. Just wait 1 second, okay? Just give me 1 second. Okay, it is not available over here. Okay, this is the table. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the table is visible,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, the table is visible to all of us. So we'll try to find out the value. Okay, this page, we read the heading of the table. Very important. Present value and future value tables, table 1 or A1. Future value interest factors for $1. That is for 1 rupees, $1, it's the same thing. That is future value. We have to calculate the present value. So we will come to this table. This is the present value table. Okay. If you look at, can you see my mouse cursor? Yes, you can. So if I show you more clearly what is happening, see, we were also calculating if we take the rate as 10%. If we take the rate as 10%, see, okay. If we take the rate, just assumption, okay. I want to explain the table to you. I'm just explaining the table, so please be patient. If we take the assumption of 10%, so 1 divided by 1.1, that means the value of 1 rupee. Before, value, the present value of 1 rupee after 1 year equals to 0.909. If you look at the table closely, see, this is 10%, this is 10%, and this is year 1, it is 0.9091. If I calculate for second year, this would be 0.8264. If we go at the table, look closely, 0.8264. 0.264. Okay, are you getting what is happening? If we take the rate 11%, then this is going to be a discount factor. If we take the rate 12%, then this is going to be a discount factor. Okay, are you getting what is happening? Yes, yes, sir. Clear. Now we'll go to. Okay, so this is the future value table, and we have to calculate. What do we have to calculate? We have to look at that. We have to calculate, see, I'll write it again. At what rate we have to calculate the rate? 1 rupee equals to 4 rupee in 6 years. 1 rupee equals to 4 rupee in 6 years. This is what we have to calculate. So at what rate? So this is going to be an answer somewhere over here. 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, any rate. This is going to be an answer. This is the time. So this is 6 years. Can you see 6 years? Yes, we can see 6 years, right? So we have to see that at what value or at what rate 1 rupee will equal to be four rupees in 6 years. So we have to talk about 6 years. So we find four. It is over here somewhere between rate 25 and 30, 3.81 and 4.82. So it is between these rates somewhere 4 is going to lie. So our rate is going to be 25 and 30. Okay, if this table is correct, let me just go through it once again and make sure everything is right. This is the present value table, the present value interest factors. This is future value interest factors. Okay. Okay. If we go back to the question. The rate is 12 and 13%. Why is this 12 and 13%? I don't know what is going on. This should not be what is happening. But you get the idea, right? I'll just see, you know, maybe the table is incorrect or something is going on, something is wrong. But you understand what we have to do, right? So this table will not be given to in the question. It never happens that the table is given to in the question. That is why IRM method is not asked in the examination, because the table and everything is not given in the question. It is not provided in the examination. That is why the topics are not asked. But there's some problem with this, and I'll try to find out what the problem is. Okay, but this is what we do. We'll use this table that is given to us, and we'll go for the 6 year mark. And then whenever the value becomes 4, we'll go for the 6 year mark. And whenever the value becomes 4, that is going to be our rate. That is going to be our rate. For example, in this question, the value 4 lies between 4.111 and 3.998. Correspondingly, discount rates 12 and 13. For example, B to the rate 25 and 30. Okay, they're taking the rate something else, but it's fine. I'll calculate, I'll find out why their rate is different and our rate is different, but you can understand what is going on, right? So NPV at the rate 12%. NPV at the rate 12% equals to, and we'll subtract it. This is the formula. The formula is also given. Okay, this is the formula. Please pay attention to the formula. The formula is LR plus NPV at that LR. And I don't want to cover the IRR topic in that much detail, because, you know, I understand it's a little bit difficult. So let's just leave it at there. Leave it at this point. This is enough for BBA. You guys can understand what is going on. Just take one question, okay? If anybody wants to know what is happening, I should just take one question. Let's take one question, okay? So the rate that we found out, the rate was 12% and 13%. I'm taking the rate that is found out by the question, because there's some problem with the table, or maybe we're not looking at the right table. There's some problem. We'll find out the solution, no worries. So this is the rate, and the value is 4.11 and 3.998. Now the formula, look at the formula. Formula is, this is the formula. Lower rate plus PV at the rate lower rate upon PV at the rate higher rate minus PV at the rate lower rate into higher rate minus lower rate. This is the formula. Okay. Oops, sorry. That's one. This is the formula. The formula is lower rate plus PV at the rate lower rate upon PV at the rate lower rate minus PV at the rate higher rate into HR or LR. So lower rate in our question, the lower rate is 12. The 12 plus PV at the higher rate is 50. This is 2775 minus 50. Okay, this is already minus 50. This is going to be addition. This is going to change to add minus 50. Okay, this will be 2775 divided by 2825 into 1. This will be 2775 divided by 2775 divided by 2825 equals to 0.982. 12 plus 0.982, the answer is 12.982. This is our IRR. This is the internal rate of return. Now we'll compare this IRR versus cost of capital. Versus cost of capital. If the cost of capital is 12 or 11 or 10, then in that case, we will accept the proposal. And if the rate is somewhere like, you know, higher than this, 13, 14, whatever, then in that case, we will reject the proposal. Okay, this is all about IRR. I'll just tell you once again, we'll revise once again. So what is IRR? IRR is a rate that equates the present value of cash inflow to the present value of cash outflow. Okay, in all the other techniques, in all the other methods of calculation, we are using cost of capital as the base, and we are discounting all the cash inflows on the basis of this cost of capital or this rate of cost of capital. But IRR takes a different approach. IRR says, no, we are going to calculate our rate of return on the investment. Then what are we getting on the investment? And then we are going to compare that rate with the cost of capital of the company. And if the rate is positive, if the rate is more than the cost of capital, then we are going to accept the project. If the rate is less, then we are going to reject the project. This is the selection criteria. And what is IRR? IRR is a rate that equates the present value of cash inflow to the present value of cash outflow. Okay, but the calculation is a bit difficult because you need to use the table and everything. And so that is why it is not that much preferred. If we do it without using table, then this is how we'll do. I mean, time is less, so I'll talk about it in the next lecture, that is on Tuesday. So you are expected to please revise all this before coming to the lecture. And I'll tell you one easier method to calculate the rate that we found out, right? 12-13% is a very easy method to calculate. I'll tell you that method. Okay, so PV of cash flow, PV of cash outflow. This equation, the basic equation is, in case of equal cash inflows, every year the earning is same, every year the return is same. So in that case, the equation is cash outflow equals to periodic cash inflow into the cumulative discount factor. We'll divide this. The cumulative discount factor is 4. Cumulative discount factor is 4. Now we'll calculate a rate at which 1 rupee becomes 4 in 6 years. A rate at which 1 rupee becomes 4. That is cumulative. It's not just 1 rupee becomes 4. The cumulative discount factor becomes 4. Okay. And the rate is 12% and 13%. So how to calculate these rates when the table is not given to in the question? I will tell you in the next lecture. Moving on, we've calculated the rate, we've calculated the amount, but this is not exactly 4. Okay, this is somewhere between 4. Between 4. So the value at 12% is 4.111 and the value at 13% is 3.998. So this is like equal to 4. This is like, very close to 4. So the answer would be somewhere close to 13. That is, we know that the answer will be very close to 13. So the formula to calculate the exact rate is lower rate plus PV at the rate lower rate. PV at lower rate and PV at the rate lower rate minus PV at the rate higher rate into higher rate minus lower rate. This is the formula. You have to learn this formula. There's nothing we can do about it. We have to learn this formula. Now this is present value, not the discounting factor. I made a very silly mistake. We are not going to take the discount factor. We're going to take the present value. So lower rate is 12. See, this is 12, this is 13. Lower rate is 12. So we'll take 12. We'll add the present value or the net present value at 12%. Then we'll apply this formula. And the answer is 12.982. You can see it is very close to 13. It is very close to 13. So this is how we calculate IRR. And then we compare the IRR with the cost of capital. If IRR is more, we accept the project. If IRR is less, we reject the project. That is all about IRR. Is it clear to you? Kuduba, kuch baat samajh aayi kya bachcho?
Yes, sir.
Okay, is it clear? Actually, we'll talk more about it on Tuesday. You are requested to please revise the topic when you come for the next class.